What's the gift of the day today? Yeah? Are you really eager to know what's the gift that I brought for you all? Okay, but you need to wait. I want somebody who can assist me. Okay, maybe you want to come? Oh, no. Okay. Can you come? No. Who can volunteer? Who can volunteer? Anyone? You, little girl, there with a mask, beautiful mask. Come, come, come. Clap, clap, clap hands. Okay. Okay. Right. Come. You want to know what's the gift for you today, right? Can I show for you? But you need to wait a little bit. Okay. Yes. I'm going to show you something, right? Before that. Okay. Hold it. Okay. Very good. Christmas decoration. You want to know what's there? Yes? What? Eye mask, nose mask. What's that? Okay, you have an happy. Thank you. So today we have suppose Christmas. Okay. Thank you so much. I just want some volunteers from you, maybe from gents side one, from ladies side one, and from kids side one. Can I have? Yes, from a kid. Yeah, you can come representing a child, and from ladies side, one can volunteer. Maybe you with the jeans pant, please. Don't think that I didn't call those of you at back. I didn't wear my spectacle today. So I didn't. So please. Okay. And somebody from men's side, maybe you? Yes, please. Clap, clap, clap. Come here. Okay. Thank you. Now I'll give you some action you need to do. Okay. You do like this. Very good. You need to do like this. Very good. And you like this. Like this. Okay. Wait. When I show hands to you, you need to do. Okay. When I point you, right? Ready? Okay. When I stop, you can stop. Okay. Right. Super. Right. Let me check you one more time. Okay. When I do like this, all three of you have to do. Okay, right? Let's check. Very good. They have done a wonderful job. Right? Ready? Okay. Right. Music, please. Song, please. That.
இயேசு வந்துட்டா புதுசா புதுசா எல்லாமே புதுசா மாறும் நன்மைகள் மட்டும் இனிமே செய்யணும்னு நம் இதய துடிப்பு என்றுமே கூறும் நம் வாழ்வின் பாதையில் வெளிச்சம் இயேசு என் வீட்டுக்கு அவர்தான் ட்ரூ பிக் பாஸ்
அங்க வச்சிருங்க. ப்ளீஸ் இங்க வச்சிருங்க. தேங்க்யூ ஸோ மச். மியூசிக் மியூசிக் What's in that box? Can you tell me?
No, no, no. I cannot tell you.
Oh. I'm eagerly waiting what will be inside that box.
No way. You still got an activity to do.
Oh, I still got an activity to do. Do you want to call somebody here?
Yes, I'd like to call somebody here.
Oh, whom do you want to call?
One auntie with spectacle and one uncle with spectacle.
Oh, one auntie and uncle who wears spectacle. Okay, can you volunteer please? Anybody who is wearing spectacle from gents side and ladies side, isn't it? So if they come and do whatever I say, you will say what's in that box?
Yes, uncle. I will surely say what's in that box.
Oh, then that's good. Right. I just brought a gift for you all and it's there in that box. Right? Somebody, one lady and one gentleman. Can you please volunteer? Yes, clap hands for this gentleman. And anybody from ladies' side? Yes, please. Thank you. So, I got two volunteers, so you can be quiet for a while, okay?
Okay, uncle.
Hi. Thank you. Can you move a little more? Now you are 5 years old. You agree? Now you are 8 years old. Do you agree?
Okay.
Okay. That's fine. No problem. Okay. So since they agreed, I'm going to give them one thing. Okay.
Thank you, Uncle.
Right. Now, you need to throw to that grandpa, and grandpa, you need to throw to this little girl. Okay? So, at the same time, and you need to catch. Okay? Ready? Start. Music, please. Little girl, you dropped your life. Okay, now you be busy in picking it up and assembling it, okay, back. Now we both will play, okay, until she finishes. If you, right, ready, go. See, why did you miss Grandpa? Oh, he is not able to bend because he is too old. Okay, right. Okay, assemble it so we will have play again. Okay, assemble it please. So, as they keep assembling the ball back, okay, let's see who, Grandpa, the little girl, who win? Oh, Grandpa, no, Grandpa. Huh? Oh, little girl. Oh, poor little girl. Both they make tension. Okay, see, if you need help, you can ask. Okay, if you need help, you can ask. No problem. Let's see. Right? So, until, if you need help, you can ask. Okay, if you need help. Okay, until they assemble it, we will have little time of relaxation. Okay? Little girl, you can ask some help. Okay, you can ask help. So try getting help. If you ask help, then you will be helped. Okay, shall we have seen? Just nice book, isn't it? Right? No discussion. If you want me, my help? Okay. Right. Okay. This grandpa is wise. Surrendered immediately, asking help. Clap hands for this grandpa. See, this is like our life, isn't it? God has beautifully designed our life and he has given us the beautiful life to play, right? But when we mishandle it, yes, that's true that we make mess of our life, but our Lord, the Creator, is ready to help you. But only thing, the Lord says, if you want help, you can ask. If you want help, you can ask. This little girl she was not ready to ask my help. But this grandpa was ready to ask my help. See, the problem is solved immediately. The life is so beautiful. The broken life is so beautiful, isn't it? See, this is how we need to solve our life problem, right? You cannot keep on solving, but with your own wisdom, with your own knowledge, experience, or even if she asks any of yours help, that will be a wrong help, isn't it? Right? See, because I know to handle this, if this grandpa asked me and I help, and the problem is solved within a minute, isn't it? Right? This is just like a life, right? She doesn't want to solve the problem. Okay, clap hands for them. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Do you want to see what's there inside? Yes? Do you want to know what's inside? Yes? Don't frighten me. Oh, there is another cover inside. Okay, let me open for you. Do you know what's inside? Do you think ice cream? No, this gift belongs to everyone. Do you know what's that? Don't know. Everyone, each one of you can have this gift. Then what will be inside this box? Chocolates. You are really little girl. So I will show you what's inside, okay? Do you know what's inside? That is a great gift for you. And the great gift is something very special for you, right? Is there somebody who owns a dog at your house? Here, somebody who owns a house, a dog? Somebody can volunteer, please? You own a? Okay, any elders? Do you? Boy, is your mother or father here? Somebody? Come, please, Sam, brother, come. Who wants a dog? Yeah, please, come here. Okay, clap hands for him. So, since you own a dog, you are supposed to carry this. Thank you. Now, I have some questions for him, right? Do you call your dog as dog or do you have some name?
Yes, it's called Puggy.
Puggy. Okay, Puggy. The name of the dog is Puggy. Okay. Do you play with the dog?
Yes, I do.
Do you tie it outside or do you grow it inside the house?
She sleeps on my bed.
On your bed? Do you love that dog?
Yeah, truly, very much.
How do you like, if I call dog or Puggy, how do you like me to call?
Puggy.
Puggy. Do you feed the dog?
Yes, chicken.
Chicken, special. So, imagine you want to show your love to Puggy. So, one day, you need to become a dog, like that dog, okay? Now you need to eat like that dog, you need to think like that dog, you need to walk like that dog, you need to go for restroom like that dog. Will you?
I can imagine those, but I can't.
You can't, isn't it? But see, he owns a dog, but he doesn't like to call that dog, but Puggy, and she sleeps on the bed. She is so precious. He says he loves the dog, but he can imagine only, but he cannot become like a dog, right? If he wants to eat like a dog for one day, if he wants to go to the restroom like dog or think like a dog, it's not practical for him, isn't it? But do you know, there is one person who created the whole world. You know, when I come for a preaching, like a clown here, right? How many of you may accept that? You may appreciate with a tie and a coat, like pastor always comes as an official dress like that for a church like this, with a full equipped church like this, with an official dress, maybe coat and tie like that. But imagine a clown like this, becoming a clown like this. In one particular church where I gone for preaching, they stopped me preaching, you know, because it looks that I make fun of God. They said I make fun of God, they said. But you know, see, imagine they printed a notice for me, handbills for me, that I am coming for preaching like this and that. So I wantedly went like this. But they stopped me preaching is because this was not the dress that they approved. Don't allow us on the altar without the there they have a uniform, traditional. I don't say something wrong about them, But I want to give an experiential preaching. That is why I came with a clown. Imagine that was not acceptable. That was not even imaginable for that particular church. Then imagine the whole world was created. You cannot think of the size our God belongs, how huge He is. You cannot measure His height. You cannot anyway imagine, or you cannot even put Him into the shape that you can imagine. But you know, in Luke, the Bible says, the God who created the whole universe, the God, the reason for everything, He became very small, to the level of 23 chromosome, which you cannot even see through your eyes. You need a microscope to see His size. He lowered Himself. He lowered Himself to the level of 23 chromosome, right? Which you need a microscope. See, imagine His size. You know why? You know why? Just to say that I love you. Just to make you feel to the level of yours. He came to the level of yours. He lived like you. He thought like you. He lived in all the troubles like you. He faced all the iniquities like you and me. Like you and me. He lowered Himself to the level like you think, the way we live, the way we feel the hardship. He felt the climatic changes. He felt everything. See, this brother, even though he loves his puggy, he gives all the privileges. He shares the wonderful bed for everything, but to express His love, He cannot lower Himself to the level of that. But our God lowered Himself just to make you sure He loves you. He loves you, you know, to the level of this one. And that's the greatest gift for you. That's the greatest gift for you. You know, imagine, I was wondering, I do you purchase a wonderful dress on your birthday?
Yes.
Do you purchase a dress for Christmas?
Yes.
See, it's practical for His birthday, He is purchasing a dress. But for Jesus' birthday, why do you purchase a dress?
I give it to someone.
That's wonderful, isn't it? See, the birth, Jesus once, He was questioned like this. See, I was hungry and you fed me. I was without dress, you dressed me. Then they come and ask, when did we found that you are hungry? And He said, see, when you fed somebody who is hungry, hunger. When you dressed somebody who is without dress, then you dressed me, you fed me. That is how. So on Jesus' birthday, of course you can wear your new dress. I am not opposing that. But if you want to reason the God's birth, it's sharing. Sharing the love. Not only dress, not only some money, not only some time. It's more than that. It's more than that. If you can go to the level of that person and make them feel that they are loved by you, it's just because they are loved by Jesus Christ. That's Christmas. That's the wonderful Christmas. So with this message, I just want to conclude and say that let's have a reasonable Christmas. Let's imagine Christmas is just, both Luke and John, they speak about Christmas. But the way they bring out, see, Luke, he starts from a very minute, humble beginning, and he goes to the to the level of a great level. But in John, he starts from the great level, right? In the beginning, there was Word, right? That is how in John starts. But Luke starts from the chromosome level, right? From the, see the birth, see how Luke portrays the birth of Christ. See, he is the universal God. He is the King of Kings, but Mary didn't even had any type of privilege, right? Imagine I was there, and when pastor's car came, see, it came all the way to the path hall, and it came directly to this place. And the pastor's car was parked. So pastor had a privilege of space and privileges because pastor. But you know, our God, even though he is a universal God, even though he is King of Kings, even though he is an almighty God, you know, Mary didn't even had even a small privilege for his birthday. He was so normal. He had all the problem. That is how Luke portrays. That is how Luke starts. But John, when he starts the birth of Jesus Christ, when he introduces, as a mega God. See the way they both introduces. That is how we understand who Christ is, how marvelous he is. But to the level that we can easily understand his love, easily feel his love, right? The love of Christ is something like the air that we breathe. We can feel, we can experience, but we cannot see, we cannot justify. We cannot say the color, we cannot say how powerful it is. Is it? So the love of Christ is something very special on the Christmas. I don't know whether you can feel that love this Christmas. If you feel that Christmas, that's the greatest gift for you on this Christmas. God bless you. Have a blessed Christmas. Thank you.
When we all clap our hands once again for our dear brother Ramesh, esteem, for all the effort he's taken, an experiential revelatory message for us. I just sing about Christmas and how, I think it was Francis of Assisi, one of the first saints who came up with a manger scene nearly 1,500 years ago to explain to the people the birth of Jesus Christ. That's why he had all those figurines that people normally set up, saying in this kind of a situation, in this manger, in this cowshed, Jesus was born. So the people who could not read at the time will be able to look at all of the things that were there, the animals, everything, to know that God lowered himself, though he is the creator of the universe and all powerful, and he has billions of angels around him to help him and to serve and to minister to him. He came by himself and he carried his cross and he died for us. Let the love of Christ be revealed to all in this world, even in this Christmas. I was very happy to hear that Gibson said that he's buying a dress to give to someone. So each and every one of you at this Christmas, maybe you can make a decision to get something. Of course, you can get for yourself gifts and clothes and whatever you need and whatever you want to get. But also, maybe make an effort, plan, and decide maybe some little thing you can get for someone else and gift it. Not just to someone in your family, but maybe someone in the church or someone in your workplace, or you see them in your neighborhood, somebody who maybe are not as privileged as you are. Give them food on that day or buy something for them, or maybe you can even visit an orphanage and provide for them. Dear Brother Ramesh has an orphanage. You can let me know and I'll get in touch with him, and you can even provide for the kids who are there, so that God would touch them and let them also know that Jesus loves them. We just have a few minutes. Right now, why don't we stand up and look unto God and seek Him and worship Him before we conclude this morning. How many of you children liked the program that was done for you? If you liked it, why don't you clap your hands and say yes? All the children, you liked it? Say yes. Meet Brother Ramesh after the service and thank him. Say thank you, Uncle, for coming and touching and blessing us. Let us look to God, to Jesus Christ this morning. For all we need is You, O Lord.
Left my fear by the side of the road. To hear You speak, won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands and pray. To be here again, the Father's love that draws me in. All my eyes want to see is a glimpse of You. All I need is You. All I need is You, Lord. Savior once again. Would my soul be without Your Son, who gave His life to save the earth? Rest in the thought that You're watching over me. All I need is You. Oh, tell Him this morning. All I need is You, Lord. Is You, Lord. All I need is You. All I need is You, Lord. Is You, Lord. All I need is You. All I need is You, Lord. Is You. 'Cause all I all I need is You. All I need is You. 'Cause all I need is You. All I need is You. All I need is You.
Each and every one of us. Thank You for holding this earth, O Lord, and not giving up on humanity. You hold the universe. You hold everyone on earth. You hold the universe. You hold the universe.
need is you, Lord. Is you. Yes, the Lord in our lives. All I need is you, Lord. In every part of our life, we offer this song as a prayer, declaring and asking that you would come and continue to be involved in our lives. We need you for physical health. Tell him, Lord, I need you. That my mind would be renewed and be like the mind of Christ. That your spirit would be the one that would lead me. Ask him, oh Lord, I need you in all the various parts of your life, in your family, at home, in your workplace, for the things that you planned for this week that God has asked you to do, the things that are coming in this season, in the next few weeks, maybe in the next few months, for all that is going to happen, a few years. All the things that you plan and you hope for your children, for their future, for their education, for your career, for your business, for new opportunities, for the finances that you need, for the things that you need on this earth, the material things, the things that, right from a vehicle to appliances and furniture in your house to everything, let all of them be made mention. Ask God, for he's a God who said, ask and I will give it, seek and you'll find, knock and it'll be open. That's what we're doing this morning in this house of prayer. For all we need is you, Lord, for you can make it all come to pass. You can give it all to us, and you have given and you will give. Amen. He will give it. All we need is you, Lord, is you, Lord. All I need is you. All I need is you, Lord, is you, Lord. All I need is you. Jesus, come make a way for them, O Lord. Send your word, send your power, send your angels. Oh, let your healing, your deliverance, oh, let your upliftment, oh, take place in the lives of each and every one here. Receive your breakthrough at this time. Of each and every one here.
Thank you for giving of your power that is needed for them, for the things that need to take place throughout this week. Thank you for grabbing. Thank you for opening the door. Thank you for healing. Thank you for delivering. Thank you for the breakthrough this morning. We give you all the praise, give you all the glory, give you all the honor, give you all the power, and you clap your hands and thank God for all that He's done in our midst this morning.